I shall now talk about how you can define or declare a pointer to a structure in the main function and how that pointer variable can be passed to read record so that we can read data into that particular pointer to a structure. So let's say I have declared struct student record with name and mark. This typedef helps me just use student instead of typing this struct student rec everywhere. That's why I have set student one student or star one student, indicating that read record is going to get an address type of a variable. It is going to get an address to a structure. So what I am doing here is I am saying student, and let me put it like this. I am saying sptr. That means it's a pointer to a student type of a structure. Then next what I can do is I can say I am defining one structure of this particular type of variable. So some student is a variable of this type, defined using this student typedef. Now what I can do is, since sptr is a pointer type of a data, it can contain the address of this some student. So it contains address of some student. Now what I am going to do here is, to read record, I am going to pass directly sptr. Instead of passing the address of some student, I am passing sptr, because sptr contains the address of some student. Then I will show you how we can use something called as the arrow operator to print contents from sptr, or using sptr to print the content of the student. So here it is, name is %s/n, and it can be sptr. So instead of using this star operator, I can simply say sptr arrow name. All right. And I can print the person's marks as, okay, let me make this percentage d. Marks is percentage f, sorry, not d, slash n. And using this pointer operator, or using the arrow operator of two structures, I can print the mark. All right. So the advantage of the arrow operator is you don't have to use the dot and the star, because using the star and the dot, you need to put that star in parenthesis, which can be kind of confusing. So using the arrow operator, you can directly print name and mark. But since sptr is a pointer type of a variable, that's why there is a star with one student. This reading of data is very similar to what we did in the prior program. So let's take this pointer to a structure kind of a program. Okay, let's copy it and let's see if it runs. Let me get this rid of this extra parenthesis. So here it is. All right. So what I'll do is program number 7. I'll just paste it out here. Let's first hope it compiles, because you never know when you typed, there could be certain typing mistakes. All right. As expected, there are typing mistakes. Line 22. All right. Line 22, sptr. All right. Some student. Okay. There should be a comma here. All right. That's what is missing. Then, all right. Now let's compile. That was probably the only error, hopefully. Okay, now great. So enter the marks. So let's say we'll enter Anita itself, and let's see if it prints Anita and 99.56. This is looking like a gate percentile data. So now if you see, it's printing name is Anita and marks as 99.55998, because 56 is approximately stored as 55998 internally on my particular computer. So just to explain briefly, this is a structure model or a blueprint. Using the typedef, I have created a shortcut called as student. So instead of typing struct student record, I can simply say student. In the main, I have declared some student as a variable of the type student. Star sptr indicates sptr is a pointer to a student type of a structure. So in the next line, sptr contains the address of some student. When I say read record sptr, I am sending the address of some student. That's why you see the star here. I am entering the marks, star one student dot name, address of star one student dot mark. That is the reason, advantage of using this, sorry, that is the disadvantage of using the star operator, because you have to put it in parenthesis. If you take out this star, then see what will happen, because that's how you should really do, play around things, and then you'll really know what happens, because then you'll understand the importance of precedence and other things. The compiler may want. Okay, here it is. It already wants you. So here it says, this is not a great idea to try to do this. So what you can do is we can take this fellow out and we can use the arrow operator here also. Here also what I can do is I can take this fellow out and I can put this around bracket, okay, just to be, and I can say address of this particular operator. All right, now I'm using the arrow operator at both the places. Let's see if it compiles and runs. All right, so it's asking me enter the name and marks. Let me enter Anita, and this time let me give her a 99.99 percentile. Oh, it's Anit, it's fine. So again, here you see name and percentile marks are like this. So using the arrow operator is much better than using this star, putting all the parentheses, dot and all, because it's not only confusing, it is not very clear when you're reading the program. This arrow operator makes it much, much easier. So preferably given a choice, use the arrow operator. Just to get conceptual clarity, I had shown you use of star operator in the prior demo session.